Lata Mangeshkar was born on 28 September 1929, the eldest daughter of Dinanath Mangeshkar, a Marathi and a Konkani musician. Her father, Dinanath Mangeshkar, was a classical singer and theatre actor. Dinanath adopted the surname Mangeshkar in order to identify his family with his native town of Mangeshi, Goa. Lata was named Hema at her birth. Her parents later renamed her Lata after a female character Latika in one of her father's play, Bhav Bandhan. She was the eldest child in the family. Meena, Asha, Usha and Hridaynath, in birth order, are her siblings. All are accomplished singers and musicians. She received her first lesson from her father. At the age of 5, she started to work as an actress in her father's musical plays. In 1942, when Mangeshkar was 13, her father died of heart disease. Master Vinayak Damodar, Karnataki, the owner of Navyug Chitrapat Movie Company and a close friend of the Mangeshkar family, took care of them. He helped her to get started in a career as a singer and actress. She sang the song Nasuya Gade Khedu Sari Mane House Bhari, which was composed by Sadashivrao Nevrekar for Vasant Choglekar's Marathi movie Kiti Hasal in 1942. But the song was dropped from the final cut. She moved to Mumbai in 1945 to classical music from Ustad Aman Ali Khan of Bhindi Bazar Gharana. After Vinayak's death in 1948, music director Ghulam Haider mentored her as a singer. He introduced Lata to producer Sashadhar Mukherjee, who was working then on movie Shaheen, but Mukherjee dismissed Lata's voice as too thin. An annoyed Haider responded that in coming years, producers and directors would fall at Lata's feet and beg her to sing in their movies. Haider gave Lata her first major break. In an interview on her 84th birthday in September 2013, Lata herself declared, "Ghulam Haider is truly my godfather. He was the first music director who showed complete faith in my talent." In the 1950s, Mangeshkar sang songs composed by various music directors of the period, including Anil Biswas, Shankar Jaikishan, Naushad Ali, S.D. Barman, Sardul Singh Watra, C. Ramchandra, Kalyanji Anandji, Vasant Desai, Sudhir Phadke, Madan Mohan. On 27 January 1963, against the backdrop of the Sino-Indian War, she sang the patriotic song "Ae Mere Watan Ke Logo" in the presence of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the Prime Minister of India. In 1962, she was awarded her second Filmfare Award for the song "Kahi Deed Chale Kahi Dil" from 20 Saal Baad. In 1955, later in the 1960s, she composed music for Marathi movies under the pseudonym of Anand Ghan. She won Maharashtra State Government's Best Music Director Award for the film Sadhi Manso. The song Airanicha Deva Tula from the same film received the Best Song Award. Lata Mangeshkar has produced 4 films. Lata Mangeshkar has won several awards and honors, including the Bharat Ratna, India's highest civilian award, Padma Bhushan in 1969, Padma Vibhushan 1999, Zee Cine Award for Lifetime Achievements 1999, Dadasai Phalke Award in 89, Maharashtra Bhushan Award in 97, NTR National Award in 1999, Bharat Ratna in 2001, Legend of Honor in 2007, ANR National Award in 2009, Filmfare Special Awards in 1994 and 2004. She has also won 4 Filmfare Best Female Playback Awards. She made the unusual gesture of giving up the Filmfare Best Female Playback Award in order to promote fresh talent. In 1974, the Guinness Book of Records listed Mangeshkar as the most recorded artist in history, stating that she had reportedly recorded not less than 25,000 solo, duet and chorus-backed songs in 20 Indian languages between 1948 and 1974. She recorded songs in over 36 Indian languages and few foreign languages, though primarily in Hindi, Bengali and Marathi. On 8 January 2022, Lata Mangeshkar tested positive for COVID-19 with mild symptoms and was admitted to Bridge Candies Hospital, intensive care unit in Mumbai. She remained in the ICU with signs of marginal improvement in her health. The doctors treating her had taken her off the ventilator on 28 January after her health improved marginally. However, she was back on the ventilator on 5th February after her health deteriorated and was undergoing aggressive therapy. She died on 6th February 2022 at 8:12 a.m. at the age of 92.